Animal Crossing has introduced 16 brand new villagers to the game, and of course, the first thing that was on my mind is I have to rank them from the worst to the best, alright? 16 villagers stand before me. All of them look very lovely, but today we have to settle who is the best and who is the worst. Let's get this show on the road. A lot of them are great, some of them are okay, a lot of them are amazing. At number 16, we have Ace. He has a stank face, a weird hairline, kind of looking like Majin Vegeta, and his mouth is wide open. I feel like he's about to call me something nasty, and only nasty things go in that mouth. I mean, he looks like he eats the bottom of the barrel of the worms in the farm. Like, birds eat worms, right? He eats, like, the trashy worms. He looks like a middle school bully that would give wedgies, and he peaked in, like, the third grade. I'm not really feeling Ace. He's just kind of meh. Ace is a Jockville. Not my favorite personality either, and his birthday's on August 11th. Bye bye, birdie, bye bye. Number 15, we have Zoe. Now, Zoe, I mean, she's a cute girl. She looks like she would fit into the cast of Barney, but they cut her last minute. Her eyes kind of look like a fried egg that got overcooked a little bit, and it's got a little bit of those fried bits in the middle. I'm not really feeling her flow. She's cute. She's fine. But she's not really a star. You know, I like the stars. She's not really a star. She's more of like an asteroid. And also her personality is normal, which is like my least favorite personality. I'm not really feeling Zoe. She's a 2 out of 5 for me. Number 14, we have Faith. Maybe I should give her more of a chance. But I don't really have much faith in Faith. I mean, she's cute as a button. I live for her Coachella Lana Del Rey flower in her hair vibe she's going for. She's definitely cute, but is she really that strong compared to the rest of these villagers? No, she's about a 3 out of 5 for me. I like her more than I dislike her. She's cute. I'm not a big fan of the koala villagers, but I like her vibe. I like her energy. Just the rest of these villagers are very strong. I'm giving her a 3 out of 5. She's also a normal villager, which I just said was my least favorite. At number 13, we have Azalea. She's cute, but she's no Iggy. I love the flower shape that goes around her horn, her nose area. It kind of looks like a daisy flower, and it's really adorable. She's got a really cute fashion sense. She knows what looks good on her. Her color scheme is phenomenal. This color is beautiful, and I loved her wing eyeliner with her like pink eyeshadow. She's really cute, but she's not wow like the other villagers. She's a 3 out of 5. Number 12, we have Quinn. Quinn is a king or a queen or a fearless gender non-conforming legend. I'm not sure. I don't know. I don't want to assume it's gender, but whatever Quinn identifies as, they are legendary. I love the pink and purple feathering around its eye. All right. It has a big old nose. All right. It's got a big, huge honker on its face. I mean, if that thing was a Pokemon, it would have maxed out attack stats. One peck from that thing and you'll be dead in a heartbeat. You wouldn't even bleed. You'd cut straight to death. All right, that thing is a killer. Insta-death. If it was a ranking of how deadly these villagers would be in real life, I mean, this one is very, very rambunctious. Like, this one would kill everyone on this list. Very cute villager. Like the design. It's a 3 out of 5 for me. It's a little too, like, I'm not really into the Tumblr emo vibe. That's for other people to enjoy. I'm not really into it. But yeah, still a cute villager. Number 11, Fret. Fret gives me King of the Hill vibes. Mr. Midwestern wholesome dad. Like, sure, he gets grouchy sometimes, and he might yell at you to do the dishes when he gets home from a long day of work. But can you blame him? Construction is a tough business with a lot of hard, long hours. You gotta give Fret some credit. In a few years, he'll be the CEO of the biggest construction company on the island. He's a long-term investment, and I love Fret. All right, don't fret, stand Fret. He's a great villager. I'll give him a 3.5 out of 5. Oh, and he is a cranky villager, which I find funny because he gives me like super wholesome Hufflepuff vibes. So the fact that he's cranky, like, okay, I want to see it. I want to see him like let loose. Number 10, we have Ioni. All right, I can already see the Ioni stands piling up like a 5-stack of pancakes at Denny's. You guys can relax. This is my opinion. You might hate it, but I'm gonna stick to my guns. Pa-pow, pa-pow. I'll take the haters down like I'm Bayonetta. All right, no, but seriously, she's a good villager. She's not at the bottom of my list, but something about her just seems standoffish. She seems a little mean. Like, her design elements are gorgeous. I love her tail. I love her vanilla hair. But I feel like the whole galaxy theme is a bit overdone and a bit basic. It feels a little fan servicey, like they wanted to take the two most popular villagers. She'll probably be Snooty just like Judy, and then mixed it with Marshall, the most popular villager who's a squirrel, and combined the two of them, knowing the fans would eat it up. But guess what, Nintendo? I'm not eating her. I don't eat squirrels, even if she does look like a vanilla blueberry shake. She's cute, I like her, but she feels a little stale. A little stale. I love that outfit though. 3.5 out of 5 for me. Number 9, Sasha. I'm not super into this duper cutesy woo-woo-woo-woo-woo senpai villagers, if you could tell, but I do like Sasha. Her bangs are giving me Reese Witherspoon. Her eyes are cute, and I love her color scheme. She's adorable, and I love bunnies. But that's kind of all I get from her. She's cute, she's cool, but she doesn't break the mold. But she's also not moldy. She's not growing any mold on her, but she doesn't break the mold. She's cool. She's fine. She's a 4 out of 5. Number 8, Cephalobot. Now let's talk about this cool dude. I've come out in the past as a robot-hating villager. You know, I don't really like the villagers that much. And people reacted like they're the Terminator and they wanted to wipe me off the face of the earth when I said that. I don't really like the robot villagers, alright? But the tide is changing with Cephalobot. Look at the moon. The tides are changing. Cephalobot is a sweet, cool looking villager. All right, he gives me C-3PO vibes, like a droid in Star Wars. I love this fashion sense he has. He's looking like he just came out of an 80s pop music video. He's all over the place, erratic, and I love him. Also, I'm a simp for the octopus villagers. I mean, look at those robotic tentacles. Can you just think about the way they move? Oh, that'd be so satisfying. I love him. 4.5 out of 5. Eh, no, 4 out of 5. 4 out of 5. Roswell is so adorable. He looks like a piece of tiramisu. He's an alligator, and he's going to be a lazy villager, and I love the lazy villagers. His design is just sweet. Also, I love giving justice to the alligator villagers. I feel like people really criminally underrate them in the Animal Crossing community. I love, love, love the crocodiles, and I love this one. 4.5 out of 5. Marlo. Now, I know Marlo is probably really low on a lot of y'all's list, but not on mine. You can save the Marlo hate for your tier list. On mine, we love Marlo. We rank him really high. He's giving me Lady Gaga Judas music video background dancer, like he's in this dark, shady biker gang group that no one can know about. I love his little cute glasses, maybe the best glasses in the entire Animal Crossing gallery of glasses, and that's a lot of glasses. All right, that's a lot of glass. I love his eyes. His personality radiates without even speaking. All right, he didn't say a word. I know his life story. Marlo, we love you. 4.5 out of 5. Number 5, Petri. I have a childhood friend who gives me major Petri vibes, and that's all I can think about when I look at Mr. Petri. I can't tell you the name of this fella because he might get a little angry, but I have no choice but to stan Petri. I'm not 100% certain on Petri's gender, so I'm going to use they, them pronouns again. I love the Pokemon Red and Blue Charizard Blast Toys themed ears they have. The glasses are so dope. They rival Marlo for best glasses in the Animal Crossing universe. I love that little smile. Like, part of me is freaked out by Petri. Part of me is in love. All of me is intrigued by him. I love, love, love that a doctor is in Animal Crossing. Like, full on doctor. Like, what the heck? Does Petri have a PhD? I'm gonna need some certification and paperwork before he starts putting needles in Pom Pom and Zucker. I know they got fleas, but probably need some vaccines. I'm gonna need to see some credentials first, Petri. I'm gonna need to see the paper. 4.5 out of 5 for Petri. Rio! Who wants to rock with Rio? I love this girl with all my heart. The first perfect villager, 5 out of 5 on this list. Everything about her is the bee's knees. She's the tea, she's Jasmine, she's Earl Grey. She's everything to me. From the stars on her cheek, she's a superstar. She's a peppy villager. So I love that she has this like star on her face. Her cute purple eyeshadow, her gorgeous feathers. Those feathers are fantastic and a great sense of fashion. This girl not only understood the assignment, but the teacher used it for examples for the classes in the future. All right, this girl has it going on. 5 out of 5. Number 3 is Chadwick. I mean, come on. Wow, what a cutie. Penguins are always cute, but this guy is giving Rold a run for his money. I love the Blue Moon popsicle in his hand. I love that it's so essential that the developers had to include it in his official art. He needed that prop badly. I love that his head looks like it has a built-in helmet on it. It's adorable. I love everything about him. His little nose holes kind of look like cute beauty marks. I love Chadwick. 5 out of 5. All right, the top two. This is very hard to decipher between. Tianxiang is a very great villager. Number 2 on my list. All right, I've decided to put Tianxiang in second place. This design is so conceptual, so well executed. He's inspired by a Monkey King. And as a Sagittarius, I live for the fire color palette. I'll be honest, a lot of monkey villagers are flops. They don't have the best design out there. But this monkey changes the game for monkeys in the Animal Crossing universe. Tianxiang and Sherry are gonna lock hands together and take over the world. All right, this villager is a hit. I love the design, but there's one villager that's slightly better. Number 1, of course, is Shino. The contrarian edgelord in me wanted to put her in second place for the drama, but I couldn't let myself do that. She's just too perfect. This might be the best villager of all time, of all 400 plus of them. This might be the best villager. She might be the best character in Animal Crossing, let alone the villagers. My favorite designs are the ones that are unique, well done, and have a little bit of wackiness to them, a little bit of whack. This chick looks like she just came from hell. She looks like Zelda villains that you have to kill in the like final boss, and that's why I love her so much. She's so different than the other villagers. She's devilish. She's spooky. I mean, heck, her birthday's literally on Halloween. That's legendary. I mean, wow. The second we all saw her, the entire Animal Crossing community said, "Who the hell is that?" She's just so refreshing to the game, and I love her, you love her, we all love her. Gotta love Shino. Alright, that's my ranking of all the Animal Crossing villagers that are coming to the DLC next month. Just a few days away, really, like a week and a half. I cannot wait. Make sure to subscribe, ring the bell. I'll be doing tons of videos about these villagers very soon when they come to the island. I'm gonna get Shino on my island, I'm gonna get Tianxiang, I'm gonna get Chadwick, I'm gonna get Ryo. Half my villagers are going to be snapped out of existence. It's going to be like Thanos is showing up, all right? Because half my villagers are going to be leaving. So, thanks for watching. I'll see you later. Goodbye. Comment down below your favorite and least favorites down below. The apple, take a bite of the apple. Take a bite of the apple. Take a bite. Make it crunch. You know it's tasty for lunch. Healthy, fruity, tasty snack. You know it gets me fit like that.